tired of going to church and not seeing the power of God move for real. We talked about that on the way here. We talked about how we expect God to move in our services. When we go through there, us three right here, we expect God to move. So now, last night's message was what?
Eulogizing God.
Eulogizing God.
And the exact title was the exchange of a eulogy. So you came and you asked for a prayer cloth for your son because he had, what was on?
He had a sore in his ear, but Zen's got several issues going on, and you just declared the victory tonight because the first of the service, you said he was going to receive a miracle. Well, we have been seeking for a miracle on behalf of Zen. The whole church has. And so last night, I eulogized my God on the behalf of my son and my husband. My husband received a miracle last night. He had 85% Thursday loss in his left hand of strength, according to the physical therapist.
Come here, husband.
I can promise you it's 110% full strength.
You had 85%, which hand you had 85% loss in?
So could you do that right there?
Grip.
Yeah, no strength as far as grip. What couldn't you grip? Show me something you couldn't have gripped.
3-pound hand piece I couldn't actually grip to pull the other.
So tell me since last night what your grip was. You couldn't have grabbed the water bottle? Go get it. You don't get it. Move. In your left hand and left arm of strength. So to grab this bottle, you wouldn't have been able to do it prior to last night. You would have been screaming in pain. Are you in pain now? Miracles in this revival. And you're receiving. And you are too, Zell?
Yeah, praise God.
You were run over by a semi.
I was on a semi truck.
So you're alive by the grace of God. And the devil thought. Huh?
With nothing to sugar with.
No.
No, I'm not talking up in here. He said all that had happened, nothing to show for it. Because that arm is working now. Somebody ought to bless the Lord. So, you got your miracle last night in the service. We declared at the end of the service that Zeb was going to get a miracle. He was at home. You went home and took the word of God. And you eulogize, which again does not mean death. It means speaking well of. So you went home over Zeb and your husband and spoke well of God.
Yes.
And Zeb is in church tonight.
Yes.
And his hearing is fine and his ear is not hurting.
On top of that, he's been a perfect boy tonight.
Amen. Yes. Yes.
So how will he have been happy? How will he have been happy?
Before church?
Yeah.
That mom didn't even know she was going to make it tonight. It was that bad.
Come here, Mom. Stand with me. Stand right here. So you didn't know if you were going to be able to make the church tonight because he was having so many issues? Yeah? But he came in here and the Spirit of God has touched them.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
And Zeb was okay tonight in service.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Amen. I'm sorry. But if that was your child, how would you be acting right now?
Come on, bro.
And that's the key. If that was your brother or your son, how would you be acting right now? When you grab a hold to the word of God, like this dear lady did last night, and this dear brother did last night, and they eulogized their God.
God, this morning. And Jack Slot, you're not going to start me right now. I was like, no, God gave you this day. So you need to say, thank you, Lord, for waking me out of that this morning.
Amen.
And he did. And, you know, the enemy just thought for a second he was going to come in this morning when Jack opened his eyes up. I'm going to tell you, he's got a loving wife that said, don't let those knees get lazy. So, about 2 seconds later, Jack was saying, thank you, Lord, for another day. This is the day that the Lord has made. We shall be glad and rejoice within.
Lord, have mercy. Thank you. Thank you. Bless you.